Hello folks, I'm here to talk to you about integrating XState with React and Next.js. And in this course, we're going to be building a to-do list app. I know it's the classic, but it still stands the test of time as showing kind of like a good range of behaviors from a library. And we're going to be using all of the cool stately tools for doing this, and you're going to be able to code along right with me. So let's get started and show you sort of what I've done so far. All I've done is I've just run yarn create next app. I think I ran npx create next app. And then I picked my directory, so my directory. And then I added TypeScript here. And that's all I've done. So what we get here is we get a list of pages inside here. So we have like this index page, which has a bunch of stuff in it. I'm actually just going to delete all this stuff just for clarity. And then I'll delete the stars from home module. CSS, I'll say hello world inside here. I'm going to delete the styles folder as well. Bye bye. And then I think inside app, I'm going to delete the styles global as well. And I'm going to delete the API folder as well. So we'll just get rid of all of the guff. And now you should be able to go to localhost 3000 and we should have hello world right here. Pretty good. So let's commit that. Let's say hello world achieved. And now we're going to just add some branches here or add some libraries. So we're going to need to add yarn, add XState, and XState React. Notice that the first one just has XState and the second one has XState with their little at the start. And we're using yarn just because I love yarn. And this is going to add the little bits that we need in order to get started with XState. And we've now got our TS config all set up. We've got our pages all set up. We've got all our TSX files working. So I think we can call that a video.